you were around, how you was when you could be found. Told them you were given downtown, driving all the old men crazy. Boys are hanging town, what you think?
The C-130 Hercules, built by the Lockheed Martin Aircraft Company, was first produced in 1956. It was designed as a 10,000 shaft horsepower, enabling takeoffs on runways as short as 2,500 feet.
I was out with the boys catching up in a neon light. Didn't know till we walked in, it was karaoke night. She was in a circle of girls chasing a shot with a line. She was laughing, they were daring her to get on the mic. One of them walked up.
Captain Stripe is now positioning Fat Albert for a low-altitude high-speed pass. From the left, at 370 miles per hour, the Fat Albert flat pass. Fat Albert and crew for today's flight demonstration are Gunnery Sergeant Brandon Paulson from Essex, Illinois, and Staff Sergeant Lauren Song from Aurora, Colorado. Over the course of a complete show season, Fat Albert will fly more than 100,000 miles while carrying a normal show load of 45,000 pounds of fuel, 35,000 pounds of equipment, and a specialized maintenance and support team of nearly 50 personnel.
She came back with me across the Vaught state line. Get the jokes on Alabama, 'cause they lost big this time. I got the number one pick, Ronnie Ridley, brought her over to the other side.
Around the world. Most recently, they've been employed in operations throughout South America, Africa, Eastern Europe, the Middle East, and Southeast Asia. And to the left, Captain Strife will establish Fat Albert on a very steep approach angle, simulating landing in mountainous terrain or a hostile environment. To demonstrate the short field landing capability, they will touch down and immediately reposition the propellers to full reverse, stopping the aircraft in just 1,500 feet. You'll notice the aircraft can not only stop quickly, but also produce enough thrust to taxi backwards. Gentlemen, with the stars and stripes flying proudly above the cockpit, the Blue Angels C-130 Fat Albert. Formation, so that you may see and take pride in the precise fashion in which your Navy and Marine Corps pilots are trained to fly. The Navy's Flight Demonstration Squadron, the Blue Angels, is the oldest performing U.S. military aviation demonstration team. Since 1946, the Blue Angels have brought naval aviation to Mr. Aries Wilkins from Columbia, South Carolina. The six demonstration pilots are approaching the end of the runway to begin their takeoff sequence. Very shortly, Commander Armatas will call for the four Diamond pilots to take fingertip formation. In this formation, Blue Angel number 4, the slot pilot, will be positioned outboard of Blue Angel number 2 on the right wing. From there, they'll initiate their takeoff roll, transition to the Diamond on liftoff, and commence the Diamond half squirrel cage on takeoff. As the Diamond clears the flight line, the two solo pilots will begin their takeoff maneuvers. In a dynamic display of the thrust produced by these General Electric engines, Lieutenant Commander Bratton will roll Blue Angel number 5, 360 degrees immediately after takeoff with the landing gear still extended. Simultaneously, Lieutenant Commander Stangel of Blue Angel number 6 will execute a precise low transition, pull the nose straight up, and complete the maneuver the half loop, also known as an Immelmann, as he exits the flight line inverted to the right. They're on the runway now, at 85% power. Carefully check their engine instruments and give Commander Armatas a thumbs up, indicating they are ready to go. With a signal from each of his wingmen, Commander Armatas will call for the selective afterburner, and the Blue Angel Diamond will initiate this afternoon's aerial demonstration. accelerating to 150 miles per hour, he'll pull back on the stick, flying the formation into the air. Immediately after liftoff, Lieutenant Goossens will call for the landing gear and flaps to come up as he moves into the slot position, and they'll commence the diamond furrow go past squirrel cage on takeoff. Smoke on, off brakes now, burners ready now, and the Blue Angel Diamond is rolling. As they pass before you, you will notice the smoke is no longer. Armatas calls for the deselection of afterburner by the four diamond pilots. Angels 5 and 6 are rolling. Blue Angel number 5 will complete the dirty roll on takeoff, while Blue Angel number 6 executes a precise low transition and pitches up vertically at 6 times the force of gravity. Flying as one in this graceful 360-degree rolling maneuver.
He's the Lord of Monaddy, unleaded in smokes. High from the series and let down horse cars.
Inverted flight capability of the F-18. Approaching inverted from the left and right, They will roll their aircraft 360 degrees, crossing over center point. Ladies and gentlemen, the opposing inverted to inverted roll. And Lieutenant Commander Stangel will establish a mirror image formation. However, look closely as both aircraft are in the carrier landing configuration as they approach for maneuver we call the Fortis. As they execute a maneuver that is performed by no other jet demonstration team in the world today. From the left, the Diamond Dirty Loop. That could be a fantasy. I can tell you got big energy. It ain't too many of them that can handle me. But I might let you try it off the Hennessy. Make them sing to this thing like a melody. And if your girl ain't right, I got the remedy. It ain't too many of them that can handle me. A 7.5G after burning turn and exit the flight line vertically, showcasing the Super Hornet's turbo nose low capability. Separation, the flight leader and slot pilot are both in the inverted position. From the right, the Blue Angel double farvel. Five and six are approaching the flight line at 400 miles per hour. And they hold their aircraft 270 degrees and cross with minimum separation. observe as both pilots sustain 6 times the force of gravity to cross their aircraft over show center. With a combined closure rate of over 800 miles per hour. Ladies and gentlemen, the opposing horizontal rolls. Has smoothly shifted back into the Blue Angel Diamond. Line abreast, flat pass. Exit to the left, Commander Armatas calls for another formation change prior to detaching Blue Angel number 5. And it's real to me, there must be someone who's feeling for me. Ladies and gentlemen, the opposing 4-point hesitation roll. What you know about rolling down in the deep when your brain goes numb? From behind the crowd, Commander Armatas is rolling out the diamond formation for another dynamic maneuver. Separate direction. Turn back towards the flight line. You should be able to follow their individual smoke trails as all 4 aircraft converge on center point with maximum closure and minimum separation. the double tuckover rolls. Pounds of thrust. Lieutenant Commander Bratton and Lieutenant Commander Stangel are approaching to demonstrate the slow speed handling characteristics of the Super Hornet in the clean configuration. They'll pass before you, virtually standing Blue Angels 5 and 6 on their tails. At less than 120 miles per hour, the fly-by-wire flight control system provides the slow speed handling that sets the Super Hornet apart in the air-to-air combat arena. Ladies and gentlemen, the section High Alpha Pass. Center point. Delta set used by the five wingmen.
We got nothing but time to lose. We gon' ride it all night. It'll be just me and you. Now to turn on the map like we ain't coming back. Leave it all up in that rear view. And take a little slow ride. get the BST. My God, girl, you're so hot. Let's find that spot where we can let our head down. Forget that truth or dead town.
The Delta is making its approach to the flight line. Approaching center point, the entire formation will separate in dramatic fashion. Ladies and gentlemen, the Blue Angel Delta breakout. Placed upon naval aviators is that they be able to land their aircraft on a ship at sea. Whether it be a tactical jet, propeller-driven aircraft, or helicopter, each requires skill which the naval aviator must master. In order to perfect this skill, Navy and Marine Corps pilots spend a great deal of time in the landing pattern, practicing carrier approaches. In front of you now, Commander Armatas and his wingmen are demonstrating a simulated carrier pattern. Approaching the runway from the left, Commander Armatas is confirming the landing checks have been completed and that each aircraft is in fact ready to land. Rolling out on final, they'll make constant power and lineup corrections, maintaining the optimum rate of descent for the proper touchdown point. Demonstration pilots you have been watching perform here this afternoon are but a small part of the Blue Angel team. The men and women in the blue uniforms standing before you are members of the elite Blue Angel.
Would they bring one extra one with them just in case?
After completing a short game of debrief, the team will come to the track line. They'll have an opportunity to meet them. as they step away from their aircraft, I'd like to take this opportunity to introduce the demonstration pilots you've been watching perform here this afternoon. It has been an honor, and our pleasure, to perform here at the Columbus Air Show this, our 25th flight demonstration of the 2023 season. Ladies and gentlemen, fly Blue Angel number one, the Phantom and flight leader of the Blue Angels, Cedeño, New York, Commander Alex Armatas. Flying Blue Angel number two, the right wingman from Yorktown, Virginia, Lieutenant Commander Chris Kapuschansky. Flying Blue Angel number three, the left wingman from Moundsview, Minnesota, Lieutenant Amanda Reed. Flying Blue Angel number four, the spot pilot from San Francisco, California, Lieutenant Gentlemen, representing your United States Navy Marine Corps, the 2023 Blue Angels.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up.